Watch Olivia York on ABC 6 News every Saturday and Sunday.
And with a wail of a siren, the 4th of July parade in Austin got underway. As the caravan slowly wound through the 22-block-long route, it seemed to have all the trappings of any hometown celebration. There were clowns and floats and bands and even a visit by some international celebrities who didn't have much to say but were a favorite of the crowd anyway. There were, however, several things that made this parade very different than any other. For one, there was an abundance of spam-related paraphernalia in honor of the Lunch Meat's 50th anniversary. And there was an abundance of people, something which may not have been possible a year ago at this time. The long labor dispute divided the town, and though the past has not been forgotten by anyone, people seem to be willing to join together to honor the country and Independence Day.
Region 6, Austin. And now, from your regional news station, this is the 10 o'clock edition of Region 6 News.
Is this good for...
Good evening, everyone. Our top story tonight is a major blow to the area's economy as a large company announces hundreds of layoffs. Seaboard Foods, the owner of Farmstead Foods, is shutting down a large chunk of its Albert Lea operation. Region 6's Rick Bussler is in our newsroom with more on this breaking story. Rick, what have you learned today?
Now, 6 News First. Good morning.
Hello and welcome to 6 News First. Good morning. It is Monday, June 14th. I'm Lou Arnes.
I'm Nat Roars. Thanks for joining us. Right now it's 6:30 and time to take a look at what's going on in the weather world. And to tell us, here's meteorologist Tim Albertson.
Nat, Lou, good morning. Good morning, everyone. Some light showers moving through the area on our Midwest Wireless Storm View. The heaviest batch of rain now crossing Highway 218.
You're watching ABC 6 News at 5 with Betsy Singer and Chief Meteorologist Rusty Dawkins.
Thank you. Well, for the first time ever, there is winter testing underway, looking for any dangerous side effects of road salt.
It's just a vacant lot now, but 1 year from today, you might be coming to this spot to shop at Austin's new Walmart Supercenter. I'm Dan Conrad. I've got the story coming up in a live report.
High gas prices could be more than just a pain at the pump. I'm Lauren Dittmer. I'll tell you where else it's affecting local residents.
And Minnesotans may not have to deal with a higher gas tax after all. Good evening, everyone. I'm Nicole King.
And I'm Brandon McElwain. Your news starts now.
Your news and weather source, ABC 6 News.
Thanks for joining us. Well, it's not much now, just some dirt and some construction equipment. But a year from now, there will be something on that lot.
That's right. ABC 6 News reporter Dan Conrad joins us now live from the site of Austin's future Walmart store. Dan?
Brandon and Nicole, the future took a step forward today. Yeah, there's not much here now, but as you can see behind me...
You would rather do the work ahead of time than have to respond to an emergency. It's more important for people to be happy and safe.
This morning on ABC 6 News, we'll show you what some volunteers are doing to make sure our homes and our families are safe.
And friends and family continue to search for a missing Minnesota man with new clues coming from surveillance video.
You're watching ABC 6 News Good Morning with Rachel Wick, Brianna Long, and Storm Tracker 6 meteorologist Cindy Morgan.
Good morning and thanks for starting your week with ABC 6 News. It is 5 o'clock on your Monday, October 12th. I'm Rachel Wick alongside Brianna Long and Cindy Morgan.
Good morning, everyone. Definitely did not feel like October yesterday. Felt a little bit more like August, Cindy.
Yeah.
Your in-depth look at local news. ABC 6 News at 5.
In this half hour, could another small town school be forced to close? The latest in a local district that has parents up in arms.
Plus, chemical weapons, just the latest weapon at Ground Zero on the war against terror. But first today, a suspicious package, alert FedEx workers, and a clever undercover operation that ended at a high-profile Rochester hotel. Thanks so much for watching today. I'm Betsy Singer. One man is under arrest after police say a package with more than $120,000 of meth inside was set to be delivered to him at that Rochester hotel.
Your in-depth look at local news. ABC 6 News at 5:30.
Tonight at 5:30, officials in Texas say the flooding is an unprecedented situation and something they had never seen before. And Governor Mark Dayton's legal team goes up against a legislator in front of the state Supreme Court. But first, a teen dies after jumping into a river in northern Minnesota.
You're watching ABC 6 News with Olivia York, ABC 6 meteorologist Jim Peterson, and sports with Diana Canizero.
Police say one person is dead after a shooting at a gas station in Crystal.
Your in-depth look at local news. ABC 6 News at 6.
A Rochester man is hospitalized after being attacked by his own dog.
And a warning for drivers from MnDOT about pedestrian safety.
But first, a fire in Minneapolis that killed three children over the weekend is prompting a conversation about fire safety. Good evening and thanks for choosing ABC 6. I'm James Wilcox.
And I'm Laura Lee. Three children, all under the age of six, died this weekend from a fire sparked by an oven used to heat the house.
Your in-depth look at local news. ABC 6 News at 6:30.
In this half hour, a campaign to get more allergen-friendly options seems to be growing nationwide.
Now at ABC 6 News at 10, officer-involved shooting. An investigation is underway after cops shoot a man dead in St. Paul, what authorities say led up to it. Plus, eye-opening audit. A federal investigation reveals some disturbing findings at Minnesota daycares. And e-cig decision, what a ruling tonight by the Austin City Council means for those who use electronic cigarettes.
Your local news and weather source, ABC 6 News at 10, starts now.
A man is dead in St. Paul after an officer-involved shooting. Good evening and thanks for choosing ABC 6. I'm James Wilcox. That shooting happened just off Interstate 94 around 3 this afternoon. New information continues coming in. Witnesses describe an irate man with what appeared to be a rifle screaming.
You're watching ABC 6 News at 10 with James Wilcox, Laura Lee, Storm Tracker 6 Chief Meteorologist Chris Kubal, and Sports with Gina Rantz.
Millionaire Robert Durst is in jail tonight facing.
Your in-depth look at local news. ABC 6 News at 10.
Investigators say the family of a missing girl is in Fillmore County tonight in the hopes of finding the 15-year-old who they believe met up with a man she met on social media.
News everywhere it happens. ABC 6 News Good Morning starts now.
Good morning on this frigid Monday, the new start of the week.
I just don't want to show this. There we go.
But you did remind me last half hour, it's not as bad as it was yesterday, Jim.
Right. It could be worse. That's true. Is worse. Northern Minnesota, Duluth is at 20 below with a 40 below wind chill. That's what we had over the weekend.
Bus stop weather on ABC 6 News is brought to you by Menards. Stay tuned for Weather First on ABC 6 News. You're watching ABC 6 News Daytime with Devin Martin, Jesse Klinger, and Weather First meteorologist Jim Peterson.
Welcome back. We're taking a live look outside at downtown Rochester with our Broadway Plaza Tower cam again in downtown Rochester.
You're watching ABC 6 News with Betsy Singer and ABC 6 Chief Meteorologist Chris Kubal.
The Friday Night Lights over high school stadiums are on, and our Shields Game of the Week, powered by Rochester Motor Cars, has a great game slated for tonight.
Six News at 10 starts now.
Tonight at 10, a Blooming Prairie woman who pleaded guilty to murder in Florida was sentenced to life. What this means for her charges in Minnesota.
Plus, flu cases on the rise across Minnesota. What one school is doing after 300 students were absent from illnesses.
You're watching ABC 6 News Tonight with Betsy Singer and Chief Meteorologist Chris Kubal.
We have interviewed these leaders, emergency managers, separately, many times. But as our conversation progressed with the fire chief, the police chief, and our sheriff, it was clear to see that they each have a pretty close bond with each other.
ABC 6 News Good Morning starts right now with weather first.
Good morning, everybody. It's 5 o'clock. Happy Friday. We are starting off our finally Friday. Very nice area-wide. We'll track that coming up.
Coming up on ABC 6 News Good Morning, Dancing for the Arts dance competition is this weekend, and you might see a familiar face. Plus, Austin Police is providing an update on a missing 13-year-old girl, what they want you to look out for. But first, law enforcement from our area sharing why they believe a bill seeking to legalize recreational use of marijuana is a public safety issue.
Thank you for joining us on this Friday morning. I'm Jesse Klinger.
And I'm Devin Martin. The Anti-Narcotic and Anti-Addictive Drug Coalition.
ABC 6 News Daytime starts right now with weather first.
We are tracking 70s once again for the midday for the third day in a row. Another beautiful day to wrap up a very nice summer-like week across the area, especially the second half.
Today on ABC 6 News Daytime, the weekend is almost here, which means it's time to do laundry.
So it's really about getting one that works for what you are typically laundering and whether you routinely have heavily soiled clothes.
We share which laundry detergent products come out on top. Plus, the Iowa Supreme Court has issued its ruling in the appeal from Governor Kim Reynolds regarding pandemic records.
Thank you for joining us on this finally Friday morning. I'm Devin Martin.
We'll have the breakdown of what to expect coming your way.
Right now at 5, Iowa's legislature wraps up today. Tonight, a look back at the most high-profile bills passed. Plus,
you're just as guilty if you're involved in planning it.
Explosive moments from a D.C. court tonight as the leader of the Proud Boys, along with three others, found guilty of conspiring to disrupt the certification of the 2020 election. And the Austin School Board considering a shakeup that could affect some of the youngest students in the district. Not all parents are pleased. Every Thursday this month, we are focusing on mental health, a series called Mental Health Matters. We're talking about why it's so important to know about mental health and the struggles people face. We're looking at the stigma surrounding it. ABC 6 News anchor Devin Martin tonight shares how you can get the help you need when you need it most. Point, how you wouldn't believe how many Minnesotans are being turned away and why it's getting worse.
Plus, a disturbing string of arrests in northern Iowa and southeastern Minnesota, all related to child porn. We'll break them down for you.
But first tonight, we are learning more about the cyber attack within Rochester Public Schools, what the district says about who's responsible and how it could impact private data. Good evening and thanks for being with us. I'm James Wilcox.
And I'm Robin Wolf from Rochester Public Schools announcing tonight that the cyber threat detected about a month ago was a ransomware attack.
The district also tells us that the personal information of some employees and students was compromised during this. ABC 6 News reporter Maisie Olson joins us now to tell us a little bit more about this attack. This was about money, Maisie.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, this happened last month, James and Robin. And the announcement from the district reveals not only the scope of the attack, but the nature of it.
ABC 6 News at 6:30 starts right now with weather first.
It's mild, but not for much longer. We move through the next hour or so. We're going to start to see that colder air moving in on our western edge. There is actually some showers pushing in. We've been watching the tower cam, some returns pushing by just past Albert Lea. Pretty dry air mass.
ABC 6 News at 10 starts right now with weather first.
60s for those temperatures entering 10 o'clock. It is mild outside. After a clear day, we started to gather some clouds into the evening. Not much happening on the rain front thus far, but just knocking on our western reaches.
Some showers trying to slide in. So begins a daily rain opportunity. I'll let you know what to expect in your weather first forecast ahead.
Right now at 10, former Hormel CEO Jeff Ettinger could be heading to college. He's one step closer to heading up to University of Minnesota.
Plus another fire in Mason City as a garage goes up in flames. More on the extent of the damage.
And new information on the impact of the cyber attack on Rochester Public Schools and how it's impacting students and staff.
Good evening and thank you for joining ABC 6 News tonight. I'm Robin Wolfram.
I'm James Wilcox. Tonight we are following developing news. Former Hormel CEO Jeff Ettinger could be the next leader at the University of Minnesota.
Yeah, he's been chosen as a finalist for the interim president role.
This is KAAL Television, Austin, Albert Lee, Rochester, Mason City.